We can install the Python interpreter by downloading the latest version of Python at python.org/downloads. I already have that page open here in the browser. At the time this video was recorded, the latest version of Python is 3.8.5. I'm currently using a Windows 64-bit machine, but this download button here will give me the 32-bit installer. If you're on a 32-bit machine, then you can go ahead and click on this button to download it. But for me, I'm going to click on this link that says Windows so that I can look for the 64-bit installer. And then here under the stable releases for the latest version, which is Python 3.8.5, I will choose the Windows x86-64 executable installer. And once the download is complete, I'll open the folder where I downloaded the installer file. And then I will double-click on the installer to start the installation process. Now, before you click on anything else, make sure that the Add Python 3.8 to Path checkbox is checked. We'll see why this is important later on, so please make sure that it is checked. Then click Install Now and wait for the installation process to complete. Once the setup is complete, you may or may not see an option to disable the path length limit. If you see the option, you can just go ahead and click on it. And then let's click on Close. And that's it. To verify that we have Python installed, let's go down here to the search field and type Python. And if everything was successful, we should see Python appear in the results. You'll most likely see more than one thing come up here because the installation process adds a lot of different components. For example, here we have the Python manuals, which we can read to learn more about Python. But the official manual can be a bit overwhelming, so don't feel intimidated if you find it difficult to understand. Remember that this is a beginner's course, so we are going to start with the basics. And now that we have Python installed, we're ready to go ahead and start writing some code in the next videos.